There we go. Okay. It works now. Yay! It works! It works! Okay. It works now. Of course, my air conditioner turns on as soon as I begin the stream. It is 89 degrees Fahrenheit outside in the shade, so I am leaving my air conditioner on today, no matter what else happens. Okay, so let's get some tunes on. And hop into oxygen not included. And if I have done everything correctly, I should be able to switch OBS over to game capture, and it should see oxygen not included. Maybe kind of, sort of. Any minute now. Any minute. There we go. Okay, it's got it. Sweet. Okay, so this is continuing the stream that I did a couple of days ago, two or three days ago, and started a new colony on Terra to sort of show how I go through my colonies, what I'm looking for, what I prioritize, how I sort of handle scheduling, all that kind of thing. And I think we left off at cycle 20, either going into cycle 20 or something like that. So I've done a little bit of work off camera. We're actually rounding out cycle 29 right now. I just did a little bit more organization and tasked some work orders, so we're picking up pretty much where we left off. What do I really need right now? Probably a farmer, I think. Doctoring, no, that's okay. 7 excavation and digging. I've actually forgotten what we have for workers right now. That scratching is annoying. Let's get to a different song. Okay, we have 2 diggers already, Devin and Trivaldo, but I don't think either of them... Did they both start? Oh, I know he didn't start. He must have started with like a 3 or something in this. Devin and Trivaldo, let me go check on these guys. Personal interest, supplying and digging. Suit wearing, tidying, and building, so none of them are dedicated diggers. And we're looking at somebody with early bird. Oh, but she's unconstructive. Okay, never mind. No, scratch that. Totally scratch that. Farmer with an iron gut, so you're not going to worry about food poisoning from being a chef. Do we have any cooks? Bert. Ah, that's right. Bert was our dedicated rancher. Looks like he has... Yeah, dedicated rancher. He had a starting quantity of 7 husbandry, so he was a single interest rancher, which means he doesn't have a lot of farming skill, so I could actually probably make use of a dedicated farmer, and that'll cover both sides of the coin, both sides of the food coin. So I think I'm going to get that person. It'd just be nice to have some more hands on deck, basically, to share the workloads. Let's hire Meep and put him onto the other schedule once they get through the night here. Of course, he starts out with a skill point already, so let's get him into his job. Okay. And you should be sweep only. You are sweep only. Why is there an egg there? How'd the egg get there? It's been a while. I haven't looked at this since early yesterday. I've kind of forgotten what I had going on, to be honest. Alright, so let's speed up time. The current work project is to set up a water filtration room off to the side of the base, so I can put in a water-based bathroom right here. And that will allow me to do away with the outhouses and start producing some polluted water, which I could then filter out to a hydroponic tile where I can install a thimble reed and start slowly accumulating some reed fiber. Domesticated thimble reed grows through its full maturation once every 2 days, so really fast, like probably one of the fastest plants that we have in the game. And you only need 2 reed fiber per exosuit, so if I start this early, I can actually get a pretty good jump on our needs. And I do want to go out to the slime biome, because there's a lot of things out there that I want. And we have another slime biome right here that is kind of thermally encroaching on our space, so I'm probably going to attack this one first, try to dig it away, get its resources held back, and once that's done, I'll probably move into the northwest one, which seems to have a larger area, more stuff to work with. So, multiple reasons for going into the slime biomes. One is, like I just said, for getting reed fiber seeds, but also for the dust cap seeds, so I can start converting my food crop farms from mealwood over to dust cap, and then I can start cooking mushrooms here at the electric grill, turning fried mushrooms and stuff, which are a really good long-term food source. Other reasons are gold amalgam, which is excellent for all of your hot machines that you'll be building in the very near future. Sedimentary rock is very thermally conductive, so it's a good material to put into places where you want heat to be spread out evenly over places. Polluted water has a broader freezing and boiling range than clean water, so you can use it more safely for your metal refinery, your liquid-based metal refinery. And you need the slime to feed the mushrooms, and you can also find little pockets of algae to keep your oxygen diffusers going and postpone the need to switch from oxygen diffusers over to electrolyzers, which I haven't researched yet, apparently. So there are all kinds of reasons to go into the slime biomes pretty early. Yes, you run the exposure of tangling with slime long, but once you learn to deal with it, you really should prioritize going into slime biomes, because they're just super duper helpful for fairly early game. Okay, so let's get this moving along. I'm gonna bring the priority up on this one notch, hopefully encourage them to do it. Get a priority check to the rest of our base, just make sure we're not too distracted right now. Food situation is really good. We have 26,000 kilocalories of lice loaf, which is, I think, plenty for our 6 duplicate population, which reminds me, Meep is supposed to be on the other schedule. Sorry, Meep. Yeah, so we'll get him onto there. Does he have a bed? He does have a bed. Okay. We got beds. Cool. He's all set. Hungry. He'll be okay for tomorrow. Okay, so I'm going to lower the priority on these plants, because I don't think we really need anybody stressing over getting the job of plants done. You are eventually going to do ranching, so I'll put you up there once you're capable of dealing with it. And Bert is our dedicated cooker, but then Meep will also be assisting with that very soon. So I'm going to wait until Meep comes on as our secondary cooker, and then I'll deprioritize everybody else from doing that job so our dedicated chefs do it and earn skill for doing it. Alright, cool. We got our ground laid out. Let's start installing the stuff. This is just a little arrangement that I've been experimenting with and haven't found too many problems with it, so I'll keep it going. So it seems to work okay. Now, the water sieve, in the process of filtering out the pollutants from the polluted water, will drop polluted dirt onto the ground, and polluted dirt, not exhales, what's the word, off-gases? Off-gases polluted oxygen. Just like the compost bin, same deal. It has polluted dirt sitting on the ground in front of it, or sometimes it does, I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The compost bin stores polluted dirt, and off-gases polluted oxygen, as you can see these little green bubbles that come up. So, because the water sieve has that in effect, I like to drop a couple of deodorizers right next to it to try to minimize any wafting away of polluted oxygen that might go elsewhere in the base. Okay, so these guys will be working on the machines. I guess I can get a little wire installed as well. And once they have that done, I will start working on the bathroom and the piping. Put this on low priority for now, but I'll upscale it when I'm ready to actually start using it. And this arrangement will make sense once you see the buildings come into play. Okay, clean water is going to come from here. And then polluted water is going to go back through the underfloor like that. Clean water... I'm sorry, I put that to the wrong spot. Clean water goes there, comes out of there. So clean water from the sieve goes into the storage tank, comes out of the storage tank, and gets distributed out to the facilities. Then polluted water comes all the way back and goes up to there, and you can jump the gap to go into the sieve. And we'll install our other little gap jumpers, aka pipe bridges. Close off the room so it actually becomes a true colored room. And then that'll be our new washroom. Once that is totally built and I've charged it with the polluted water that I've been storing up from the wash basins over here. See it right there, we'll get some dirty looking polluted water there. Once this has been pumped into the water sieve and we've charged the liquid reservoir with a little bit of clean water, I can dismantle these guys. We'll get the remaining drops of whatever's in the wash basin at that time. We'll go into here. That'll be our final charging of the system. Then I can dismantle the liquid pump, dismantle this washroom, and start using the space for something new. And then we'll be totally on a closed loop system of a gray water recycling, perpetually recycling toilet flow, basically. That's the plan. That's our first major accomplishment for the stream. And speaking of the stream, let me go check on chat and give you guys an update. And what the plan is. Hello, Jerry. Did everyone work off camera? Normal chance to beat the game. And yeah, well, you know. So let's see. Hello, Mark. Hey, hi, Mark. Bye, Mark. Okay, so this stream was requested by. Well, this little series, I guess, was. No, let me rephrase that. In the announcements a couple of days ago, I put out a request for people to vote, but unfortunately the everyone ping didn't actually ping, so I only got like a couple of votes. But the couple of votes I got were for Auction Not Included. So that's what I did a couple of days ago. Sam ended up watching the first stream and she requested that I do something of a tutorial style of videos. So I'm just playing a little bit along that lines. But it got me thinking, you know, what is some good advice for how to kind of go through Auction Not Included. And just from memory of playing past colonies, I started writing out all of the major milestones that I go through. Yeah, the last one's a joke, by the way. All the major milestones I go through in trying to complete any given colony that I make. And I organize them, or I categorize them into local tasks, which we do right inside the... Oh, I'm sorry, you guys can't see... I totally forgot OBS is on GameStream. I'm sorry. I've been pointing with my mouse this whole time. Okay, so here we go. Announcements from a couple of days ago. Nobody saw my everyone ping. Got a couple of votes for Auction Not Included, so that's what I played a couple of days ago. Then Sam made the request that I do the new series. So here's the file I've been talking about for the last minute or so. I made a list of milestones that I kind of go through when I'm playing my colonies. And like I said, the last milestone's a joke, because, you know, whoever actually bothers to win one of these games, the idea is to keep it going as long as possible. But I organized the milestones into local, nearby, and remote. Now, the local one is all the tasks that you can do using... almost exclusively using resources that are within your starting temperate temperature biome. And when I say temperate temperature, I'm talking about green color on the thermal overlay. So all the starting biome, basically, all the resources that you have in the starting biome, those usually will be enough to get all of the local errands done. Caregiver, I would like to have a doctor. but I have other interests I'd like to be associated with caregiving, so I'm going to leave that alone right now. It's not really a good combo. For my interests, it's not a good combo. I already have some diggers. I just hired... No. The digger that I was going to hire had a negative trait. Of course, you also have a negative trait. But that's 10 digging. Do I want to pass up 10 digging? Do I want to pass up 10 digging? Is there a way I can overcome the noodle arms? I might have to micromanage Harold a little bit. There's some tricks you can do to sort of force them to increase their strength stat. I might get him, actually. I actually might do this. I mean, 10 digging, 10 excavation. That's... yeah, I might actually do this. Okay, let's take him. So anyway, the local errands you can do with all of your local resources in the starting biome. The nearby errands assume that you're going to be going into things like slime biomes and hot biomes, maybe even saltwater biomes. And with most of those resources, you can get accomplished most of the other tasks in this section. Once you start getting into the remote errands, you're talking about going down to the bottom of the map for oil, or depending on some of the other unique map types, you might be going out sideways or even up to try to find little pockets of oil. And then from oil and plastics, you eventually start ramping up your overall base cooling, which allows you to ramp up your steel production, and then you can start getting into rocketry, which happens at the top of the map. So all these things are stuff that happen well outside of your base, a good safe thermal distance away from your base, so you don't have any heat cross-contamination with other sites. So this is kind of my workflow. Hey, Mythos is here. Hello, Mythos. Alright, so switch OBS back over to game and continue the process. Okay, they are working on the piping. That's good. I'm going to let them do that. I'm not going to bother upscaling the priority. Just let them take care of their own business. I just hired Harold. Does Harold have a bed? Yes, he does. Okay. Harold's all set. Come next morning, I will have him go... actually, because he has that negative 3 strength problem, I'm actually going to have him focus on doing supplying first to try to counteract that just a little bit. Because I like to pair supplying, building, and digging together, and then tidying if I have room for it later on. So I'm going to have him take supply first, try to smooth out that rough patch in his stats. And then just for Harold, I'm actually going to set up a little training room to have him sleep in and try to increase his strength stat by sort of micromanaging his time. It's going to be a bit awkward, but it can be done, and it's better to do it early than later, because I think it takes more effort, more experience to increase their skill later on once they already have some skill under their belt. Okay, looks like we're not researching anything. Let's have Ren get back on task with doing some research. And since we are looking at plumbing stuff, I want to make sure I have all the plumbing I will need prepared. We have some radiant liquid pipe and the thermal aqua tuner. These things are very helpful for cooling off your metal refinery coolant and for cooling off your electrolyzer rooms to make sure that you're not filling your base with superheated air. So these things are nice to have, but I don't need them right yet because I'm not really ready to do either metal refining or electrolyzer rooms. So I will research this, but I'm not going to research it right now. There are probably some other things I can do that are slightly more important. And going along with not needing the electrolyzer right now, I will also postpone researching this because it's not super essential right now. So plumbing is taken care of for now. I think we're okay. We can look elsewhere. Like I said at the end of the previous stream, I did do some more researching into decor, so I had all the paintings available once we go find some reed fiber, and I got the first couple of nodes of automation just so I have that as an option whenever it comes available for use. Of course, I won't be able to build anything automation-wise until I have some metal refinement, or some refined metal, and that begins with the rock crusher, but ideally should transition as soon as humanly possible over to the metal refinery. So, I guess I could start researching these and get ready to do some metal refining. But is there anything else I need sooner than that? I'm not really keen on doing a whole bunch of ranching just yet, so I'm not going to worry about the critter sensor, which again needs refined metal to make. We're not ready to do crude oil or plastic production. Don't think there's anything else we really need. I could probably start getting the refined metal underway. We're not going to need the exosuits anytime soon. Actually, you know what? Because I'm going into the slime biomes pretty soon, and thinking about the reed fiber, I guess I might as well get the reed fiber out of the way, just so I can start making it as soon as possible, or start using it as soon as possible. Yeah, that's what we'll do. We'll research exosuits, the exosuits forge, and the textile loom. Get those things ready, and then once I'm done with those, I will start researching the metal refinery. Once the metal refinery has been researched, I will go into all of its supporting infrastructure. Once its supporting infrastructure has been built, namely conductive wire so the metal refinery doesn't overload the basic wire gauge, and the smart battery so we can make better use of whatever energy resources we're using. And then once that is done, then I can start preparing to go into cooling systems, namely the thermal aquatuner, radiant liquid pipe, and the electrolyzer for isolated oxygen production rooms. That is my sequence of research that I'm going to follow from here on out. Let's see if I remember all of that in the coming hours or so. probably will forget all of that in just, you know, a couple of hours' time. Let's see how we're doing thermally. I do have some insulated tile here blocking off this lower section. Unfortunately, it meant my base substructure is shallower than I usually go. I usually have it go at least one more level down. But I'm not sure if I want to get that close to a bunch of heat. I might tunnel underneath this. Now that we have a safe buffer of carbon dioxide sitting down here, I might actually open the space up, hollow it out, and drop this floor down by one more so I have some more room to grow crops. Because our population is continuing to grow. And I have water sort of interfering with the other spaces, so I can't set up a crop farm over here just yet. That's not a bad idea. Let me do that. This mule was just harvested. Now is a good time, as good a time as any, to go and do this. So let's do that. I just don't want the shine bugs to escape. That's my concern. If I can box them in sooner than later, that'll be helpful. No, shine bug, go back. Go back, little shine bug. Stay over there. Come on. Oh no, Lyra's gonna get trapped. Lyra, you need to be on the other side right now. Don't anybody go over there. Oh, not good. Oh, sweet. Okay, that was actually really successful. Nice. Okay, we will continue hollowing this out. So, I want a farm floor there, and actually the insulation will go across here. That should be good enough for most of my needs. So this one was a little bit extra. I went a little bit too low there. That's okay. A lot of people with loud vehicles around here. I think I need to improve this bathroom. No, you know what? Let's upry the piping, let them finish the piping job. And then, oops, I didn't mean to do that. And then I can start installing the bathroom. It'd be nice to get this up and running sooner than later, so I don't have to keep fiddling with this now understaffed, undersized bathroom that I have. Alright, check on chat here. Oh yeah, we can check out our little park sign here. And actually, it's not a park per se, because a park only needs two wild plants. The nature reserve is workable when you have four native wild plants, and we actually have five in here. We have the five cultivatable ones and the one decor one, so we actually have five plants in here that are contributing to our nature reserve. And every time a duplicate walks through there, they get plus six morale. And I may or may not have deliberately routed the duplicates to only be able to walk left into this room and then walk right out of this upper room, so it forces them to go in a loop. So everybody gets to go through the nature reserve. As long as they're working out here, or doing something out there. So that's helping with their morale needs quite nicely. Alright. Almost done with the piping, but we're also getting low on oxygen. I think I need to get a second oxygen diffuser going, because these little guys only produce 5, I believe? 500 grams per second, and I now have 7 duplicates who ideally consume 100 grams per second whenever they're inside the base. So yeah, I need to set up another oxygen diffuser, and my usual spot for putting it is right where this bottle emptier is sitting. So this is just further emphasizing that I need to get the washroom up and running as quickly as possible, pump the polluted water out of here, and then I can put in the second oxygen diffuser right there, and that'll be a nice symmetry across the base. But we have plenty of oxygen to last until then. It should only take a couple more days to get this done. Now, do we have the metal for it, is the next question. I started looking around trying to find places that I could do some more digging out of copper. There was a seam of copper right here that I dug out, and that seam continues over here, so I can go get some more right there. There's another little seam down here that I can get, and once I pump all this clean water out of here to go into irrigation or the washroom, I can then come down here and get this last seam of copper right there. And after that, the only other place we can go to find any is way down at the bottom of the base, so that's going to be a long-term goal. We're not going to get any of that anytime soon. I see they are done. Alright, let's start building. And I'm going to put this on priority 6, just to make sure they get it done. Now, there are a couple of ways I like to build this. For a long time, or at least once I have 2 washrooms up and running, I like to do a sink and a shower with a lavatory in between the two, because the sink and the shower contribute positive decor, whereas the lavatory contributes negative decor. So I kind of sandwich the negative decor in between the 2 positive decors. And then, as you can see, I have room for a second set of this trio on the back half. But since I only have the 1 washroom ready to go right now, and because we have a fair number of duplicates, and we're starting to get to the point where we have 3 duplicates per shift, I'm going to forego the showers for now, because they're not essential to any kind of function of the duplicates. And for the time being, I will just do 3 lavatories and 3 sinks. It's getting a little bit loud on the music. Okay, while they are working on that, I can get my recently researched crown molding up and running. Make it out of granite, because granite gives a +20% decor bonus to any innate decor values of this. So the innate value is +5 decor per installation of crown molding. Increasing that by 20% will give me +6 decor spread out over 3 tiles per installation of crown molding. So that's why we use granite. Now, you can't go all the way across like this when you're using showers, because showers are actually a 4 tile high building, and the room itself is 4 tiles high. So I'd have to remove some of these crown moldings to install a shower, but that's okay, small price to pay. I also took some time to install some storage bins. If you may remember from last stream, I had a bunch of planter boxes out here with some mealwood in them, and once the mealwood had finished growing, I took those out and started making room for storage, and I went around a lot of the base and got rid of a lot of the debris that was here. So the debris from the bedrooms, I started getting rid of that. Got rid of all the stuff around the kitchens and the exercise and research areas. Speaking of research, it is already done. What was the next thing I was going to do? I think I said metal refinery and then metal refinery infrastructure. Okay. So, they just built that already. That means we can get this going. Let's start building the pipe to get the stuff out of there. I'm just going to do a direct connection like this.
How's our power situation? Can we spare the power? Can we spare the wattage? It's a 240 watt pump. And yes, I can spare the wattage just for this one little construction errand. Okay, let's check on chat again here. Maybe it's because I've been Portal obsessed for the last couple months, but I think it would be really funny to see Interstream Portal. God, Portal was the first game I ever bought on Steam. No joke. First game I ever bought on Steam. This was back when it was almost new. I don't think I bought it new, but it was almost new. Portal is a good game. Portal 2 is pretty good too, but I don't remember if I actually finished it or not. New printables. Okay, what do we get here? Doctoring plus 7, that's what I like to see, but you are biohazardous, which means you can succumb to all kinds of things and then not be a very good doctor. Doctoring again? Nope. Pitch pepper seed would be okay. I don't think we're in any hurry to get those done, though. Tidying, supplying, and ranching, that's not too bad. But you have allergies, so every time you run by Allergy Farm. Eh, I used to think allergies was kind of funny when they introduced it not very long ago, but the more I've experienced it, especially in the over the long-term course of a base's evolution, the more I realize how annoying allergies can become, because it really, really, really slows down a duplicate. Like, you look at the negative trait of narcoleptic, where duplicates will just randomly fall down and take a nap wherever they are. We know from playing this game that narcoleptic causes a very significant delay in productivity, or a decrease in productivity for that given duplicate. Allergies causes almost the same amount of decrease of in productivity, because whenever the duplicate sneezes, they stop and do this huge, dramatic, overblown sneeze and continue on their way again. And I want to say it also does a little bit of harm to athletics, although I might be misremembering that. But anyway, basically allergies sucks. Don't hire anybody with allergies. Don't hire an inter. I am allergic to everything in the world. So because none of these guys are really up to snuff, I'm just going to get the pinch of pepper seed. Done. Alright, let's see. I'm going to lock this door so I don't climb over the bottom one. The bottom one can be open because we don't mind shine bugs getting in there. And let's set the sink directions to right so duplicates only use them after exiting the toilet. Okay, are we ready to pump? I actually think we already did pump, didn't we? Yes, we did. We just need power for that. Okay. Actually, I can't give you power because that will put us over. It'll put us to... Actually, no, it'd be exactly 1,000. I could do that, couldn't I? Well, it's not super essential to have it right now, but at least I can build the wire. Just get the wire ready to go. For now... Are we in the middle of a shift? Let's wait until these three guys get down their bathroom break, and then I will quickly dismantle this, sever the wire, turn on the water sieve, and get the first flow of water going. Okay, so there's two of them. Ren and Harold. Where's Trivaldo? Here comes Trivaldo. Alright. He is done washing. Exit. Let's kill the sinks. And raise that up to a 7. Guys, kill the sinks. Delete them, please. Guys, Bert, we need you to do this. It's much more important than producing power right now. Much more important than producing power. Come on, guys. Destroy the sinks before the next bathroom break. Do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. Do it, do it, do it, do it, do it. Do it faster. Faster, 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 faster. They're not going to make it. Alright, we're just going to deal with the overloaded wires for a little bit. Sucks to be us, but we're going to have to. Alright, start producing some clean water. Thank you. Somebody just installed the filtration medium. It can now filter out the pollutants. We got clean water. Lavatories are ready to go. Did they get rid of it? Yes, they did. The last of the polluted water has been delivered. We can kill the pump. Kill the pump. and get rid of all that. Cool. All right. Ready to go. Let's get rid of the lavatories so I don't accidentally, or the outhouses so I don't try to use those again. And then the remaining polluted dirt will be brought down to the compost bin for processing. And that is it. The situation, the pump there, or the bottle emptier, and install that much needed second oxygen diffuser. And I can finish that ladder at long last, I've been waiting to draw down here. Alright, there we go. We ran out of power again. Why did we run? Oh, we ran out of power because of... Right, I knew that. Bert's like, hey man, you told me to get off there. I'm sorry, Bert. Go run on your little treadmill. Oh, now he's hungry. What the heck are we listening to? This is a really boring song. Let's backtrack a little bit, see if we can find something else. Let's see. Jerry, dude, Portal 2 is great. It's a lot longer, though, and I find the puzzles can be quite unclear at times. Yeah, Portal 2 was made for co-op, right? I mean, they expected you to do co-op during it, so I suspect that you're supposed to have somebody else's eye or different vantage point to try to solve the clues or whatever. That's the impression I get from my old vague memories. Alright, let's start building these in. I guess we can't do that one just yet. I could probably just do a ladder straight down. I don't think it's any kind of harm to put a ladder right there. Okay, while they're doing that, I'm going to start rewarding their digging efforts by breaching into the slime biome. Now, what I like to do as soon as I get in here is make a place, a permanent place, where I'm going to have a storage bin that is dedicated just to storing slime. And I think this spot right here is probably as good as any. So let's see if we can get over there without accidentally digging up any slime bits. I'm actually go one up and then crawl down. That slime's gonna be in the way, but that's okay, we'll deal with it. Jerry, I think it's intended, though, as it gives you time to take everything in. Yep. Mythos, if you reject all, does it make the refresh rate for the portal shorter? I don't think so. I think it's always 3 cycles. I think that is the continual rate. I've never noticed that it went shorter. Although, maybe they changed that recently. I'll try that next time, Mythos. If I see the option to do so, I'll try it. So does that answer maybe to my request on the streams? I would have to reinstall Portal. I haven't played it in years. Yeah, I could try it. I don't know if it would actually look very good, because Portal, you really want a high frame rate on some of those little stunt jumps that it makes you do. You don't want to be looking at that at a slow frame rate that my computer would have. So I'm not sure it would make for the best streaming content, but yeah, I can look into it. Okay, let's get our mushroom farms ready to go. Wait, no, hang on, they haven't even built the insulated tile yet. Come on, guys, what are you doing? I have 7 people on staff now. You should not be this slow anymore. Are we good for... Oh, yeah, we're good for algae. We have 21.8 tons. We are good for algae for a while. All that sand is just going to fall down. Okay, let's go back out to my little cheat sheet. Toilet water. Okay, so we got that accomplished. All of our local tasks are done. Now I'm moving on to the nearby tasks. Okay, so back on stream chat. Jerry, don't think it is, but those. So all this indoor recycles, yeah, I do think it's just a constant 3 cycles, refresh time. Essentially a 3D printer, not a portal. It's a printing pod. It's, I mean, yeah, okay, I guess. I'll give you that one. I'm reading the chat because I have OBS set to be on game stream. Like, right now you see it's on desktop, but as soon as I click my mouse right here, it'll switch over to game stream. And that switches OBS to only look at full screen applications, which in this case is Austin not included. Unfortunately, most of the games I own don't work well with OBS's game stream full window capture kind of deal. So it's really frustrating. Most of the time I stream with OBS on desktop view because that's the only way I can get it to work with a lot of my games. Like KSP is not compatible with full screen viewing from OBS. The ground in KSP turns black if I try to do a game stream. What sorcery is this? Yeah, what Mythos said. As for co-op in Portal 2, the co-op makes it a lot less interesting for me personally. Yeah, I had some concerns about that. Didn't Portal 2... I know I never finished Portal 2 now that I think about it. Didn't Portal 2 offer some kind of feature for map building, though? I thought I did. I thought I'd give you an option at some point to make your own maps in some fashion. Oh, come on, guys. Just finish that one load. Just finish it. There you go. Okay, finally. Let's build. And we are going to want another tunnel back over to that room. None of this is high priority, though. I'm going to let them work on that when they feel like finishing it. Everything else is going to be low priority down here. So I do want to keep the shine bugs in place. Okay, in the meantime, let's upscale the priority on the... Oh, shoot, they got it. They're done. Sweet. Okay, that worked awesome. Thank you, whoever got over here. It's probably my recent excavation hire. It's probably Harold. Trivaldo, do I need a diamond and obsidian mining? Diamond and obsidian is good if you find a geode or a buried geyser, or if you want to go into the oil biomes, but I don't think we have any of those in play right now. Terra does not have any geodes. I'm not seeing any buried geysers anywhere on the scope, which is really quite depressing, to be honest, because I'd like geysers. And we're nowhere near the oil biome, so I don't think we need obsidian and diamond mining right now. We have natural gas over here and the saltwater geyser. And again, the reason I have this much of a view is because I briefly turned on sandbox and opened up the reveal tool and started waving my reveal wand around to pull back the fog of war. So we have a destination to go over here to get the natural gas geyser for power and the saltwater geyser for a renewable source of water. And I'd like to go get some Weasworts at some point since Terra does offer them. It's nice to use them when you can. They're a very low-cost, low-maintenance cooling system. Not a very powerful cooling system, but if you put them into something like a crop field and just let them work slowly over time, they are a great asset to have. So I'd like to get some of those at some point. But yeah, I don't see any cultivatable soil. I don't see any buried geysers or volcanoes or anything like that anywhere on scope. So yeah, we don't need super hard digging. Let's have you train in standard digging, or standard building rather, because I do want some builders. Oh, see, you already have it. What the hell? Okay, yeah, you're going into construction as well. Ren, you are done with your researching, man. What else do I want to have you do? I don't know. Do I want to have him just go straight into astronaut? I'd like to have my best researcher actually stay on researching and then have a secondary researcher go and do astronaut stuff, because you still need somebody staying at home while the rocket is away on its space flights, working at the telescope and continuing to research other destinations. And when the rocket comes back, you want to have a non-stressed, ready-to-work researcher to process all of the astronomical data that they bring back on the rocket. So I actually think you need two researchers per base minimum. One to do the research throughout the entire colony's lifespan until you've completely filled out the research tree and researched all of these rocket nodes. And meanwhile, while your rocket phase of playing the game is in play, you want a second researcher who can train into the suit-wearing things and go become a rocket pilot. So, I don't really want Ren to be a rocket pilot. I don't want him to be an astronaut. I want him to actually do something else. But since he is my best researcher, and eventually I need to go out and do geographical analyses on geysers to know when they're going to be active, it would be nice to at least get him to the point where he's okay walking around in an exosuit so he doesn't take forever to commute to and from the various geysers all around the map. So I guess for right now, the best thing I can do is just get him up to the point of exosuit training, so that begins with supplying. Lyra, what are you doing? You're being my mechatronics engineer. Keep on working toward that. Once you've got that, then I'll start giving you your much-desired construction. Okay, I think we're all set. Where did we leave off? Looks like Ren's done researching something. He got done the metal refinery. Let's get the conductive wire so we can actually make the metal refinery. Kind of getting ahead of ourselves, though. We don't really need refined metal anytime in the super near future. It'll be nice to have when we can get it, but it's not an essential thing right now. So I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself with the refined metal. I really want to focus on agriculture, and specifically using these fungal spores to make dust cap mushrooms so I can start cooking some mushrooms. Okay, but now we have this storage bin exposed. Let me go to organics, select... Oh, I can't select slime because we don't have any slime dug up yet. Okay, in that case, somebody come up here, pry 9, dig up a couple pieces of slime. This is not going to be sweep only. I'm going to have this be active constantly, so they always know to go toward it. And I'm going to put it at priority 8. There we go. They've just dug up some slime. Let's go back to organic. Reselect it. Go back to organic and select slime. Now, this is priority 8, and they should immediately put it in there. Come on, Devin. Come on, you can do it. There we go. And now the slime is in there. I'm going to say disable disinfect so they don't keep going back and trying to disinfect it every few seconds, because it'll be continuously contaminated with slime lung germ. But there we go. With the slime lung now being stored in here... Oh, I have printables available. One second. Hang on. Printables, you can hang on a second. Now that I have the slime lung stored in here... Not the slime lung, the slime. Keeping the slime... nuggets, the little things that sit on the ground. Once I keep the slime nuggets stored underwater, under any kind of liquid, it prevents them from off-gassing polluted oxygen. And by preventing them from off-gassing polluted oxygen, it prevents them from putting their slime lung germ into an airborne state, which means that you don't contaminate the surrounding environment. So you always want to try to keep your slime submerged. Store your slime submerged. SSS. Store your slime submerged. Okay, so there we go. That task is done, and now that I have that there, I can freely go around now and just bulldoze the entire zone and start harvesting it for resources, like the fungal spores. So since we have a couple of fungal spore seeds, let me start planting those. Oh, we have 4 of them. Shoot, wow. Okay. Copy. And paste. Let's get those going. Love to have those up and running sooner than later. Now, let's choose our duplicates. Do I need another rancher right now? Oh, a rancher with diver's lung! But he can't do cooking. That sucks. A rancher with diver's lung. Oh, come on, man. That's so good. But he can't do cooking. Here's the thing that annoys me about that. I love to have my cooks, like Bert, do farming, ranching, and cooking. That's a trifecta. I love having all 3 of those together. Having somebody who can't do one of them, like he literally can't do cooking, means that I have to put him into some other task that he probably isn't really suited for, and doesn't really mesh well
with his schedule of tending to crops, tending to animals, and working at the stove. Right? That's a pretty synergistic occupation of his daily time, is those three tasks, because they all are interwoven. Farming, ranching, and cooking are all interwoven. So I hate seeing this, but Diver's Lung, a rancher with Diver's Lung is just so tempting. I really, really want that. Farming, doctoring, ranching, offering, building. It's him or the Pipsqueak. It's him or the Pipsqueak. You know what? I might try Mythos's thing of rejecting all, just to verify that, because it should reset to three cycles. What's our food situation right now? Yeah, Lysolf is starting to go back down. We actually need to catch up on food. So let's postpone increasing the population right now. I really would like that, but I don't like that. And the Pipsqueak is just going to be annoying right now. Pipsqueaks are okay. They're kind of fun. They have their uses, but they are not native to the Terra asteroid type. So getting one from the printing pod is kind of cheating a little bit. So I think now is as good a time as any to test Mythos's hypothesis and reject all and see if that increases the refresh rate. Nope, next print is still three cycles. So it's the standard duration. Okay, and somebody got a skill point. Meep got a skill point. Let's have him do cooking, because I said I was going to have him take that over. And now we can have Bert and Meep be our dedicated cooks. And everybody else will go on low priority for that. Okay. Good. We have a bunch of colony achievements. Let's walk through those. Let's see what we get. To pay the bills, outdoor renovations, It's Not Raw, and Royal Flush. So, It's Not Raw just means somebody used the grill. Outdoor renovations means we built something outside of the base. Royal Flush is having a washroom instead of a latrine, getting rid of the outhouses. And what was the other one? Oh, to pay the bills just means that somebody got the entire line. This was Devin. So somebody filled out an entire row of related skills. That's to pay the bills. So those were the achievements we got. Alright, check on chat here. OBS might record on a screen, not the actual screen it makes. Yes, yeah. Oh, am I still on? I am still on desktop. Never played the game, didn't know it was... Oh, cool. Yeah, thanks for this. As for co-op, okay, so I missed that. Oh, yeah, I saw it now. My eyes wander. Yeah, they made a map building tool. Oh, they did, okay. Oh, okay, but you tried it and it wasn't that good? Alright. By the way, Drew, it's a good thing that you haven't touched Portal in years. It means that the puzzles will be new to you. Yeah, well, should be. Slime Log, did ONI predict coronavirus? Why Rancher and Diver... Rancher combined with Diver's Lung is nice because a lot of the times my ranches will be in a place that is... Oh shit, they can't get down. Will be in a place that is far removed from the main base and therefore has a substandard oxygen flow. So if I can have a rancher go up and work in a low oxygen environment and not harm themselves, that's just helpful to my overall workforce. It's not super essential. Eventually I will populate my ranch spaces, my ranch rooms, with plenty of oxygen, but it's not always a high priority, and if there's any kind of cutbacks I can do on my base to try to keep oxygen inside the main core of the base, ranches are usually the first thing I cut off from oxygen. And then so my duplicates end up going up to the ranches and start holding their breath while they're trying to do grooming tasks. And it doesn't work out very well. When I first started doing ranching, when the ranching update to Oxygen Not Included was new, I actually made the mistake of putting my ranches down at the bottom of my base in the midst of a whole bunch of carbon dioxide, because I was thinking, well, hey, critters don't mind carbon dioxide. You know, hatches can breathe in whatever atmosphere you put them in. They don't mind.
So I thought, well, hey, hatches can survive in carbon dioxide. Why not put them down there? Because it's a bunch of space below my base that I can't use. Might as well use it for something. And I made the mistake of having ranches down there. So then my duplicates, my ranchers, were coming down trying to do grooming tasks, and they were running out of oxygen, holding their breath, before they could finish the grooming task. And so they were spending literally in-game days trying to do one single grooming task, and they could never finish it because they could never hold their breath for long enough. So the one time it ever worked was when I accidentally just happened to get a rancher who had the diver's lung trait. I was like, aha, light bulb. So that's why I kind of, that's another reason why I like to focus on it or put some emphasis onto it. Okay, I want to get that polluted water out of there. Let's just have them mob it for now. And we'll just dump it back into the room. Okay, and then I can start getting rid of all this. Got another fungal spore. Let's have them use that. Come on, fungal spore. How many do we have? We just had the one. Okay, cool. So the tiles that the mushrooms are growing in are now starting to accumulate slime lung. That is expected because they are being fertilized with slime. And slime carries slime lung, so that's no surprise there at all. Now, uprooting these guys and getting rid of the polluted tiles is an entirely different micromanaging task that takes a lot of effort and a lot of time, a lot of patience. You have to have an ample food supply kind of stored away to tide you through that demolition process, because it does take a lot of time and patience. But it can be done. It can be done. All right, I need to give Harold a unique bed. Harold's the one that had the massive excavation. Yeah, Harold's the one with the low strength. I need to give Harold a unique bed in a unique room and micromanage his time to give him a plumbing task. I don't need a whole lot of space though, that's a nice thing. But I do need space to keep other duplicates from going near him. So let's try, well, let's just put this roof in right now, I think. I'd really like to put the roof of the building up a little bit more, because the base feels a little bit cramped. I usually like having one more floor above this, but I guess I can make do without it for now. I'll probably change it before next stream, but for now it's fine. So let's finish that room. Yeah, just have them go through it. Go get them, guys. Alright. And what else is happening? Research needs to continue. So, okay, we have the conductive wire and we have the metal refinery. I might as well set aside a place to build that. Before I forget, I want to get the and or buffer and filter gates, because those are useful for a lot of things. The exclusive ore and the memory toggles, they each have very helpful purposes in situations where they're needed, but it's rare that you need them, so I'm not going to worry about those right now. But these guys, these four, definitely want these. Very, very helpful. So let me get those researched, since we now have access to refined metal. And I think I'm going to start weeding these guys out. We're having heat issues, the mealwood can't grow, the bristle blossom is almost too hot already, and it has no illumination. I think it's time to get rid of this natural farm that I was kind of utilizing for a while. It's had its day. You know what? Since I'm going to get rid of this farm and raise the roof, hate to do this to you guys, but I'm going to not do the insulated tile. Let's go back to normal tile. Sorry about that. Sorry about that. This one could be an insulated tile. We do need that. Let's get ahead of ourselves. And let's actually build the thing we want right away. Unfortunately, that means I'm going to be trapping a lot of hot material, hot solid material inside the base, and I don't really have a way of getting rid of it unless I dump these things on the floor, copy their settings to some exterior bins, sweep all the hot material out to the exterior build bins, and then dump the exterior bins onto the floor and copy their settings back to the interior ones, and then re-sweep all of the cool material that's sitting on the ground inside my base. If you don't go through that micromanaging process of your materials, what you end up doing is having a bunch of hot material stored at storage bins that are somewhere inside your base, and they contribute to the interior of your base warming up that much faster, which really sucks. So it's a hassle, but it has to be done. You have to micromanage your solids. Or you should, if you don't want to worry about having to cool your base down very quickly. So I was talking about these guys. Let's put a lamp up here. Get you growing so I can get a final harvest out of you. And that'll do it for you. Different songs, wrenches music, and... Okay, there we go. So what if you're wrenching something that doesn't like oxygen? Ah, well, in that case. For example, the Trekkos. There are two sources of reed fiber in the game, and in one of the patches from last year, the developers made reed fiber a much more important component of your base progress. You now need reed fiber for suits that are for clothing that you make, which was always the case, but you also now need it for exosuits, and I think also jet suits, but don't quote me on that. And you need it for all the paintings, the canvases, things. You need it for all of those as well. So reed fiber, actually I think you need it for carpet tile. I've never, in the history of owning and playing Oxygen Not Included, I have never once built a carpeted tile. But you probably need it for that as well. Now because of that, because reed fiber is so heavily needed nowadays, you have to consider your sources for it. And there are two sources of reed fiber. One is from thimble reed, which naturally grows in the slime biomes. I'm trying to find one, but oh, there's one. Here we go. Thimble reed, which of course happens to be next to cold biome, so it's too cold. But thimble reed is one source, and the other source is Trekkos. The standard species, standard breed of Trekkos. So when you harvest a Drekko using the shearing station, this little monstrous looking machine right here, the Drekko basically acts like a sheep in Oxygen Not Included, and you shear off its wool, and its wool drops as reed fiber. Sorry, my voice is going on me. We got another colony achievement? What did we get? Good, anyway, nobody cares. Video, nope. Okay. So, the problem with using Drekkos is they do not naturally regrow their wool. They only regrow their wool in the presence of hydrogen. And hydrogen is usually in rooms like this, where you have hydrogen on top and chlorine on the bottom. And of course, neither one of those are breathable gases. Or you just have isolated rooms where there's nothing but chlorine or nothing but hydrogen, and you have to move the Trekkos into a place where there's nothing but hydrogen and just hope for the best. But yeah, and in any case, for those situations, the only way you can go to the Trekkos, or the only way you can use the Trekkos is to... Sorry, no, I should say only. There are two ways you can do it. One of them is much more cumbersome than the other. The easy way is to already have some reed fiber from a thimble reed in the swamp biomes, and have already turned that reed fiber into at least one exosuit, so a duplicate can walk into these unbreathable atmospheres wearing an exosuit and shear the Drekkos in situ in their natural habitat. That's the easy method. but it takes some previous resources. On certain asteroid types where the swamp biomes simply do not exist, and Drekos are your only means for acquiring reed fiber, then you have to resort to the second and more cumbersome method, which is to have a nearby pool of oxygen where a rancher can go and breathe, and then run into the Dreko, wrangle the Dreko, pick up the Dreko, and bring the Dreko back out of the room. And then you bring the Dreko to a shearing station that is somewhere back inside your base, shear them there, then wrangle them again, and bring them back to their natural habitat so they can regrow their wool back in a hydrogen biome. It takes a lot of effort. it's an annoying process. So did that answer your question? I think it answered your question. Alright, polluted water, sleep only. Actually, no, you can. We don't have any polluted water anywhere else, do we? No, we are done with polluted water. Okay, not sleep only, just go and do it whenever you feel like it. No rush. It's really weird hearing birds in a song. They're done with that. That's good. Oh, in case you're wondering, the little airflow tiles on the ends of the room are just to help with oxygen or carbon dioxide moving through the far ends of the room, so I don't have to rely on these vertical stairwells as being the only means of transporting gases. And Ren is done again. Let's have Ren go research something else. What was the next thing I said I was going to need? Maybe a smart battery would be nice, but it's not super essential. If I was doing ranching, I'd probably be going for the shipping overlay and the... Sorry, these guys. The conveyor loader and the auto sweeper. Those things, plus the conveyor rails and the conveyor chutes, of course. These guys are really important for doing automated ranching. But I'm not actually doing any ranching right now, because I don't need to. It's not super essential for survival. So, somebody's hovering outside my window on a garden tractor, and I think they want to get my attention. Let's see if I need to do something. I might need to end the stream. No, I guess they were just running by. Okay. So yeah, what do I need next that Rankin research? I guess I might as well just get the electrolyzers out of the way so I stop thinking about it at the back of my mind. Hey, the hatch is hatched. Let's wrangle him and move him over with his kin. Hatches cannot jump across two tile gaps, so I think I'd transport his egg here from some errant place where it had been lain mistakenly, and then I just had to wait for this moment to move him again. Ranching and farming, no adversity to cooking, but you are anemic, which is one of the worst negative traits you could possibly have. That anybody could possibly have. These are not very good duplicants. I guess I'll take the pufflet and just get a quick snack out of the pufflet. Bye, pufflet. Nice knowing you. There's 1600 kilocalories of meat. That's not even enough to do a single barbecue. Oh, apparently it was enough to finish a queued recipe of barbecue, though, so that's nice. And let's make sure nobody actually eats the barbecue, because nobody should be eating a barbecue right now. We should just be doing lice loaf. There we go, there's the barbecue. Nobody should be touching that. Take that off of the menu. Nobody eats the barbecues. We are not ready for that. We do not need that massive amount of morale improvement. Come on, finish this, somebody. Do not let the slime bug or the shine bugs escape. Do not let them escape. Bert, seriously? Okay, you are the chef. I'll let you have that one. Come on, guys. Somebody come to do this. You can do it. You can do it. Come on. No, there's There's one coming. No, do not go. No, you stupid little. Oh my god. Ah. Okay, emergency. Panic. Crap. Panic. No, he's coming for it. He's trying to make an escape. He's making his daring escape. Stop him. Stop him in his tracks. Shoot. No, he's trying for it. No, you don't. I do not want you coming up to my bedrooms and waking my duplicates up at night. You are going to halt right there. Your advance goes no further, Buster. Make your way back out there and I'll deal with you later, little punk. See, shy bugs used to be a nice thing. We used to like seeing shy bugs in our base. Have shy bugs flying throughout your base everywhere, it was a nice thing. It used to be a nice thing, and then they just had to go and introduce that debuff so that anytime a shy bug wakes up your duplicate at night, or any light source to be honest, light bulbs or shine bugs, and if a duplicate gets woken up at night by light, they have a huge stressor throughout the entire next day. Their immune system is compromised, their stress is compromised. It's a really nasty debuff. Developers apparently thought we needed to have that for some reason. It's very annoying. I used to like shine bugs. I loved having shine bugs just flitting around the bedroom at night. But nope, can't have them. I thought it was like, hey, it's like fireflies at night. Everybody likes fireflies. They're cute. But nope, no more shine bugs for us. Shine bugs are evil now. So saith the developers. See what that is. Just let me show me what that is. I'm curious. It's Fuckroo. Okay, nothing important. Come on, little dude. I know you had high hopes, but I can't have you here. I need you to go back out, please. Or just lay an egg so I can transport your egg back outside. You are nowhere near laying an egg, so that's gonna take a while. Ah, it sucks. Okay, let's finally finish this bedroom. Actually, let me do the roof first before I have them collapse a whole bunch of sand on me. Let's dig up the sand first. That would make more sense, wouldn't it? Okay, is this thing grown yet? It's almost ready for harvest. I'm not going to worry about the mealwood. They're not important. Just want this bristle blossom done so I can get one more harvest out of it. And then I will have my base roof more or less complete. How are you doing, oxygen diffusers? We are at 20.6 tons of algae. That means we've gone down a little bit, but still plenty to last us for a while. Check on chat again, see how we are. If only there was some way to collaborate. Yeah, I know. Well, actually, who was I was watching? Grind This Game, the YouTube channel called Grind This Game, hosted by a player who goes by the moniker Wintermute, or at least he used to. Like, my moniker is Inter, his Wintermute. But I think now he just calls himself by his channel name. So it'd be like me calling myself Inter's Odyssey, which is weird because I'm not a noun. It's not a proper noun. But anyway, so Grind This Game, he had a series where people would... what was the series called? It was, like, Pimp My Ride, but it was Fix My Base. Like, Dude, Fix My Base, or Dude, Pimp My Car, but Dude, Fix My Base. And people would send him their save files of colonies that they had started and gotten to a point where something had gone disastrously wrong, or was about to, and he would come along and work their colony until he had solved whatever problems they thought they were having. So it was kind of a neat little series. And I'm just now realizing I built these too high. Dang it. Sorry, guys. They're one tile too high. Oh, there we go. The Bristle Blossom is done. Okay, sweet. Let's get that out of the way. Kill the light. Kill the light. Kill the light. And start sweeping this all the way. And now I can finally connect these ladders. That'll be nice. Connect these levels, I mean. Okay, sand is gone. Let's have them work on the roof, and then I'll open up the interior. And Ren needs another research task. Crying out loud, Ren. Give me a break, man. And then I need a home away from home for Harold. Let's have Harold have his home away from home. I'm going to give him a bedroom elevated off the floor. I think I'm going to kind of convert this area for Harold's use. Give him a bedroom off the floor. He's going to need a bottle emptier. And... Yeah. Okay. He'll need a bottle emptier. He'll need a thing off the floor. So put that in right there. He'll need a ladder to get up to bed at night. He'll need a walking space underneath that. And he's going to need a gated room system to prevent other people from coming along and so-called helping him with his mopping errands. So I think the door should be about this far away. I'll do the doors last, I think. Okay, so that's what we need. We need all of that for Harold. This is just to get one duplicate to artificially level up their strength attribute. Yes, come on, Harold. Build your own thing. Go build your own future home away from home. Get all this out of the way, I think. Maybe not all of the way. I sort of want to keep this sealed off to some level. I think I'll just do a corner seal just to prevent the airflow from going back and forth between the top and sides of the base. No very good reason for it, just because... My only reason is just because there's a lot of heat up here and don't want unnecessarily transferring and surrounding the base as a slow death knell. Oh, we got a hatch. Let's get you down to your friends. I don't want you munching up my resources. Hatches are not crowded, and of course they're not crowded because they're in a gigantic room that is 727 tiles large. Actually, I don't need the bottle emptier on that level. The bottle emptier can be on the floor, can't it? But it still needs vertical space to sit, so one way or another. Yeah. But if I do it there, it's not going to interfere with anything. Then he has room to climb. Okay, I'm just going to slightly rearrange this. Not a big change, but just a slight one. Actually, he's going to need airflow for that. While you're over here, I might as well grab this little copper seam. There's 1800 kilograms, that's fine. I'm not worried about the floor collapsing of the water. Should be safe. Oh, the clay reminds me. Going back to my little progression cheat sheet. Better food source. We are getting mushrooms. We're working on that right now. We are looking for a long-term water source. We already have one of those in mind. It is this salt water geyser down here, but in the meantime
There is actually a lot of water on this map, so it's that's really low priority for me right now. I have a lot of options for water. The next thing is looking for weasworts if we happen to find any. Again, not a priority, but I am seeing there are quite a few around. There's two up, three up here, two there, at least one there, probably more. So there are weasworts in any direction that we travel. Insulated pipes, I already put in some of those for the washroom, but we're definitely going to need more around the perimeter of the base. And really the next thing I'm striving for should be metal refinement. That should be my next goal in the near future. Concrete fight, yeah, no doubt. No, I want my base built 8 tiles wide. No way, I want my room 7 tiles wide. Screw you. When I found this, was too fixed up and playing my volleyball. Yeah, yeah. Freshly printed, already murdered. that poor little baby puffed. He's like, why? What did I do? So what other games is there have that he doesn't play? Dude, I have so many, it's not even funny. Oh shoot, printables. Hey, mushrooms! Yay! Fried mushrooms already. Operating suit wearing, caregiver, no. This is okay, actually. This is actually okay, but... nah. The interior decorator is okay. It's not a really bad thing. But when you couple it with an interest and a job occupation that is typically going to have them be spending a lot of their time in low decor areas, like out on the frontier digging up dirt, or down in dingy, dirty areas like refining oil, you know, you really don't want somebody with the interior decorator trait to be in those environments because you're just asking for them to be depressed all the time. Hey, we have another 10 science dude. Oh! Nails, you're my astronaut. Done. It's done. You're my astronaut. A 10... Wait, hang on. Think about this rationally, Inter. You're already almost done with the research tree. Oops, sorry. You're already almost done with the research tree. Do you really need another 10 science researcher right now? I've already researched everything I can use, everything I can make right now. The only stuff left to research is things that I'm not going to be using until 100 or more cycles from now. Like plastic beds and all this crap. I mean, I'm not building rockets and all that stuff. I'm not going to be actually using any of the things that I have left to research. Maybe the desalinator, but that's a quick research job. Maybe the shipping or the conveyor rails if I do some automated ranching. Eventually I will research the steam turbine for a powerful long-term permanent cooling solution, but there's not much left to research. There really isn't. Should I get a 10 research scientist to become an astronaut? Or should I wait and get somebody who has the suit-wearing interest coupled with something else that they need, like researching or supply, so you can go up through the researching, supply, and suit-wearing tree and become an astronaut with interest in all those things? Which would be the better deal? Well, suit-wearing really isn't important. It's not a per se job, so they're not going to really gain a whole lot of experience from it, but there's a possibility they could gain some experience from walking around outside of the base doing other activities. But if you have an astronaut, the only thing you can really train them in is to become an astronaut. You really can't afford the morale cost. So you see how much the lower red bar grows? You really can't afford the morale cost to have them going and doing both astronaut training and training in some other career path. If you're going to have an astronaut, you pretty much need to have them be only an astronaut, at least to begin with, until your base is super clean, super pristine, super happy, maximum food morale bonuses, all this stuff, comfy plastic beds, everything. You need your base to be perfect before you can even consider having an astronaut start cross-training into a secondary career. So, hiring an astronaut who has the suit-wearing interest really isn't all that important, if I'm being totally honest with myself. It's really not all that important to wait around for that. And I really just do have the one researcher right now. It would be nice to have a backup researcher, just in case somebody's sleeping, just in case something goes awry, if Ren meets an unfortunate accident. I think I'm going to hire him. Bert, you are being my rancher. I think I'm going to hire him. And Harold, I'm going to work on your strength thing in a minute. Go do some digging instead. Yeah, I'm going to hire him. Nails, you are my astronaut. Come on board, dude. And you're actually going to take Harold's bed. I'm going to get Harold into his new home. The fact that he's unconstructive really sucks. I mean, the unconstructive skill, or the unconstructive trait, is one of the worst traits you can have. But it's not as bad as tryptophobia, which means they can't dig themselves out of a hole. It's not as bad as anemic, which means it takes them forever to get anywhere. But it is still one of the worst traits you can have, because it very much limits what they're capable of doing. Anytime you get an unconstructive duplicate, pretty much the only things they can do... Sorry, wrong screen. Pretty much the only things they can do are farming or ranching, or the operating things like cooking or electrical operating. Or if you're really bored, maybe just have them become a plumber. But that's kind of a waste of a resource. So, yeah, unconstructive sucks, but I'm making up for it by having him go out and do astronaut, because astronauts don't need to be architects. Alright, cool. So, let's put you on a different schedule so we're not crowding that one. I will have you go opposite of Ren. I'm sorry, if you go opposite, you'll just go somewhere else. And Harold really needs to have a new bed. Harold, this is your bed now. Where are you, Harold? There you go. Okay, let's dig out this stuff. And I can delete that. Turn that into a ladder. Okay, install the plumbing thingy. Actually, I'll have it face this way. So now Harold has a barracks once again, all to himself. Let's make sure it only goes out the door that he's supposed to go out. And to prevent other people from coming in and quote-unquote helping him with his chores, I'm going to put up another blockade. And this is why we need all the copper. Actually, hang on. You're not supposed to be a door. You're supposed to be a tile set, so I don't accidentally... Yeah, sorry, my bad. You guys can stay as you are, I think. Should be fine. That'll do. That'll work. I'll just have a ladder going across here for Harold. Actually, I don't need all that copper. Let's go with the standard tiles. No one needs to go through there. Harold can go through there. Or anyone can, I guess. Alright, and now begins the fun. Take off all access for everybody, and only give access to Harold. Harold is the only one who can go through this door now. He is the only one who has access to the space, and therefore he is the only one who's going to be putting water onto the floor and cleaning it up. Now, the danger in this little system that I'm about to do is that Harold runs the risk of contracting hypothermia, because standing in water all day tends to do that to duplicates. Oh, now there are two of them in here. God, no.
killing me. Oh man, come on. You know what really pisses me off about this is they're in the same space as my food and they're eating my food. Don't believe me? Look at a shine bug's profile. Shine bugs will eat, well, okay, not all of my food. They're eating the bristle blossom or gristle berry. They will eat your food out of your storage bins. They actually will do it. I've watched them do it. It's really annoying. Of course, they might not be hungry right this second. Oh, you're hungry. Okay, yeah, go ahead. Go ahead. Prove me wrong. But anyway, so I want them to get out of here. They really shouldn't be in there. There's no way to chase them out except to build a gate and get them closer to the door. That's a tedious process unto itself. Stupid shine bugs. Okay, come on, Harold. Fill up the floor. I want at least a little bit of water in every spot. Harold. Come on, buddy. There you go. There you go. This is all for you. Cool. How much water is that now? That's a pretty decent amount. Okay, about 100 kilograms? Okay, that's good. That's good enough. Cool. Alright, now, Harold, your job is to mop that. All day long. Now that he's in there, we do this little number and we say, you're not allowed to leave anymore, Harold. Wait, is it? Is it mealtime? Dang it. Right as I do that, he has a mealtime. Okay, go eat your meal. But basically what we do is we lock Harold into that room, and he spends all day just doing mopping and dumping errands all day long. And that feeds into, was it the tidying thing? Yes, mop. Mop and sweep, basically. But yeah, mopping things. Deliver, I guess, is also strength based. Yeah, so you have tidying, sweep of mopping up the floor, then you have delivering of sending the materials back to the bottle emptier so they come back out onto the floor again. So they're all strength related skills, and by locking Harold into the room and making him perpetually do this in a micromanaged mopping loop, you force him to build up his strength stat, and that is how we overcome the what was his thing? What was the name of his debuff? The noodle arms. That is how you overcome the noodle arms trait, is just kind of lock them into a micromanaged loop. Okay, we can get rid of this door as soon as I install this one. And finish off our roof. I think the stream is probably getting close to the 2 hour mark. Oh, it's an hour and a half. In prison during his sleep. Hey, I gotta do it. I gotta do it, man. I've never played Half-Life, and I've seen other people play it. It does not look like my type of game. Does not look like something I would enjoy. Alright. And I couldn't tell you why, because I know you're gonna ask that question, Jerry, but I couldn't tell you why. It just doesn't look like something I would enjoy. Okay, there we go. Last door. No, I'm sorry, not a door. Ladder. I need a ladder there. And then we could start replacing the insulated tile with normal tile. There we go. We can recoup some sandstone from that. Of course, it's making our bathroom going to be cluttered with debris. Oh, hang on. It's the same thermal problem that we had before. Dang it. Cancel that. I want to move those materials outside of the base before I get too much farther ahead of myself. Of course, he's not going to be able to get into there. No. Let's have Harold do that. Come on, man. Be cool about this. Think about what you're doing. Where is Harold? Is he off of his shift? Harold, where are you, buddy? Come here, man. Okay. You, sir, are going to do nothing but... Well, the only thing you can do, really. Are you a digger? You're not a digger. Oh, you are a digger. Oh, sweet. So you can do this single-handedly. Go, Harold, go. Alright. Build us some storage bins, and we're going to get all this hot, solid material out of here. Hey, whoa. That's low priority, buddy. Low priority. These are high priority. As you can see, it takes a lot of micromanaging effort. Alright. Let's keep Ren busy. Actually, Ren and Nails. All right, they can both do researching now. Go, Ren, go. Hey, Nails. Come on, buddy. Come on. Dynamic duo. Where are you? Where are you, Nails? We need you. Nails! What have you done, man? Nails, what the hell? Oh, he doesn't have researching. Oh, that's why. Sorry, Nails. My bad. I had researching priority turned off for everybody as a safety measure. Make sure that we weren't having any slow researchers working here. There we go. Yeah. Hoorah. Okay, Bert. Oh, you're lacking sandstone. Okay. Make him out of granite then, I guess. Actually, might as well make that one out of granite as well. Giggles. It's meal time for Harold. Go on out, buddy. We'll get you strengthened up someday. This is intensive strength training. I don't even have enough metal to finish the doors. Crying out loud. I need so much more copper. This is a really bad map for copper. Got hungry hatches. Stupid little shine bug things pissing me off. It's one little mistake because the duplicates couldn't build fast enough. Okay, now both of you get on that side of the door so I can close it. And then stay there while a duplicate comes running down to do the closing. Yeah, right. Wishful thinking. They're not going to want to go anywhere because they have a food supply nearby that they'd like to pilfer from. I'm just going to have to kill them. I'm going to have to take their eggs and move the eggs outside. It really is the fastest way to get them out of there. Just wait until they lay an egg, sweep up the egg, and dump the egg out here somewhere. So let's start doing that. Let's get ready for it. Ridiculous the amount of hoops you have to jump through now. Come on. No luck. Alright, Harold is back. Harold is sleeping. Harold is sweeping? Let's have you get all minerals except for sandstone. And let's have you dump those into here. You are the only one who can go through. These should be sweep only. Copy, paste, and do it. Not you. Nope. Trivaldo? No. No. Only Harold. Bert? Nope. Drop it. Okay, I keep going. Lice loaf is at 30,000 kilograms. It's actually less than our muck root now. It's a bit worrisome. I guess until I get some more fungal spores, I can risk having a few more lice loaf down here, or mealwood down here, just to make sure we're keeping supplies steady. Alright, we have two shine bugs over there. Let's do a gating system. Let's close this one, wait for this one to go into here, close this and open the other one, hope they all go out one way. Come on, make my day. Faster way to do this would be to use automation, but I haven't actually started refining any metal. I think I should probably consider doing that in the nearish future. Yeah. Okay, Harold, is it your mealtime? No, it's not your mealtime. Why are you not sleeping? Because the dirt isn't part of the deal. Okay, so your room is set. Good stuff. Let's have you go get these. Whoa. Oh, he's transporting the existing stuff outside of his room. Okay. Fine. You cannot go out this door. Nope. Harold? Killing me, man. You're killing me. Come on. Get into the room, then turn around and do the thing. Come on. There we go. Okay, now. Yes, there you go. There you go. Alright. I'll have to get that as well. New printables. Warp seed. Oh, hell yes. Digging, doctoring, tidying. Ugh. No. No. Oh, God. Gosh, that's an automatic warp seed right there. No questions asked. That is an automatic warp seed. Oh, look. It's Harold's mealtime again. I have to once again let him out of his cage. And back and forth we go. Cancel the sleeping orders to make him not... Well, actually, it should be okay, because he's going to be going to bed first before he goes back to work, so it should be okay to leave those active. Are acting like they're idle. There must be a way for water. Are we out of water? Yeah, we're getting pretty much out of water. Okay. Let's kill this thing. Get down there and mop up the rest. And since we never did end up using these guys, ice is melted from that. Don't need this pump because the pump's in a bad spot. Can start turning this into a crop field at long last. Of course, our food situation is actually doing decently well. I guess I don't need to be worried about food right now. Okay, he's got everything. Sand, dirt is the only thing left. I don't mind hanging on to those. They're a little bit on the warm side, 28 degrees as opposed to 20 degrees, but we already have a bunch of yellow in here anyway. I'm not worried about a little bit of yellow. I just don't want to have orange. I definitely don't want to have orange going into our main core base. I'm going to try to keep that out as much as possible. Okay, how else am I going to stop these guys from going places they shouldn't go? trying to think about how to keep people on task. I might have to put back a door into this floor and then have Harold be the only one who can run across it and nobody else can come up through. Might have to do that for a little while. It's gonna suck, but I think I'm gonna have to do that. Or, like I said, let everybody come into the room. Yeah, it would be a lot faster that way, but I want him to be the only one who's doing the sweeping, because I want him to get the training in it so he... Yeah, alright, that's what we're gonna do. I want Harold to be the strength guy. Alright, you finished digging that. Might as well sweep all the rest of these. Okay, put in some doors again. Speaking of doors, is that shine bug gone yet? Nope, still there. How old are you? Have you laid an egg yet? You will soon, just a few more days. Okay, Harold is done. Let's have Harold enable this until I'm ready with it. Actually, I'm never in. Hang on, I'm already ready with the doors. Okay, nobody goes up through. Nobody goes up through. The only person allowed to go down is Harold when I say so. Not right now. He can go up through, but he's not allowed to go down. Okay, Harold. You're free to exit. Please go sweep everything. It's just dirt, right? Yeah, okay. Sweep everything on this floor, buddy. Get all that stuff gone. Oh, sorry, I did a mop command. And then sweep. Go, Harold, go. Take it all outside the base, please. I want it gone. Okay, now we need water for researching purposes. Let's get that underway. So, somebody? Anybody? Thanks, Devin. Yes, good job, Harold. We'll get you bulked up eventually. Okay, stream's winding down. Let's look at what we've done so far. Owls are done. Research done. Compost is done. Ration boxes and CO2. This is all the stuff we did last episode. Beginning of this episode, I finished building the toilet gray water loop, which is this system over here, where clean water comes out of a reservoir, supplies the toilets and sinks. The toilets accumulate water. You actually get more water out than you put water in. So the extra water comes all the way back. The polluted water goes into this reservoir, comes out of the reservoir, goes into the water sieve. The water sieve turns the polluted back into clean. And eventually you build up a nice tidy supply of water. Once the clean water reservoir is filled, and you start getting some excess sitting in the polluted water reservoir, then you can siphon off another branch through an additional parallel pipe and send that parallel pipe out to a hydroponic tile. And in that hydroponic tile, you can plant a thimbleweed seed, which we have two of so far. And with that thimbleweed seed sitting there, collecting all of your overflow, excess runoff, polluted water, and being irrigated by that, gradually, the thimbleweed seed will, or the thimbleweed plant, will produce reed fiber, and over a steady period of time, you can start accumulating a fair quantity of it, and start turning it into things like paintings, and clothing, and exosuits, and carpet and tile, if you're one of those crazy people. That is our first major accomplishment for this episode. Other accomplishments, I expanded the vertical parameters of the base, making it a bit larger, a bit more comfortable, more flexibility for future buildings and constructions and uses. We hired a few more duplicates, got some more hands on hand to do stuff. We went out into the slime biome, gathered some fungal spores or whatever, and started harvesting or cultivating mushrooms. Hang on, that Harold just need to go do that. Oh, is it Harold's mealtime? It is. Let's let him go get some food. Cool. And then next time he goes back up, he's stuck up there. Okay. We collected some slime, set aside a storage spot for that slime. Slime will be there pretty much permanently. Or until I find a better spot to hang on to it. What else did we do? So we got new food. Water we're not concerned about. Put an eye out for Wheeze Wars, got one from the printing pod. Put some insulated pipes in, at least for the gray water system, because eventually this water will warm up just as it kind of absorbs heat from the surrounding environment. The buildings themselves, which are made out of metal, will absorb heat out of the air. That heat will be transferred into the water that goes through them, and also the polluted water coming out of the duplicates contributes some heat as well. So eventually your gray water system itself heats up, and that's not necessarily a bad thing, because to irrigate our thimble reed plant with polluted water, you want warm water, because the thimble reed thrives in warm temperatures. If I go back up here to our poor little chilled thimble reed, we see that it survives anywhere from 22 to 37 degrees Celsius. So you want warm water anyway. But you don't want the water becoming so warm that you can't safely use it inside the base. And for that we have insulated pipe to try to safeguard ourselves from backflow of heat. Not a whole lot else accomplished, just a bunch of planning done, kind of cleaning things up, making room, getting rid of the polluted water that we had here, making room over in this corner of the base so I can start actually using it instead of relying on water storage, and setting up Harold's training room. That's pretty much the extent of what we've done today, I think. And we'll start working on tidying up the base, sweeping up the debris off of the floor so we start getting some more positive decor around the entire base. I will take the time to install some more granite crown molding in places like the barracks and other places. Oh, hang on, I need mess tables. How did I miss that? How did I miss the fact that some people have no place to eat? That was bad. Sorry, guys. Okay, but I think that's it for the stream. That's close enough to 2 hours. My throat is pretty much gone. And I think we'll wind it out there. Okay, thanks guys. Catch you on the flip side. Oh, Veos got the message. Okay, so people saw the ping. Good, so it actually worked this time. I guess you have to have the @everyone tag be in the original message before you press enter. I wrote the message, pressed enter, posted the message, and then I went back and edited the message to include the everyone ping, and I guess that's why it didn't happen yesterday, or the couple days ago, so whatever. Alright, that'll do it for the stream. Thanks guys, catch you next time.